All right, quick, turn around, look.
Yeah. Guys, come on, everyone turn around.
Turn around, where's she going?
Come on, get
over here.
Ready?
Arm,
Cole, can't see. Arm, get next to Cole. Arm, get next to Cole.
Everyone look this way.
There you go.
There you go.
Yay.
So
nice job.
Awesome.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks so much for sticking around and hearing us speak today. Let me introduce some of the folks up here on the stage. My name is Chris Spiam. I'm the Long Island Event Coordinator for the Empire City Garrison. We're the New York Garrison for the international costume organization known as the 501st Legion. We also have our commanding officer here today, Anthony Palladino. Give him a big round of applause. We all put this all together with about 35 characters today between the 501st Legion characters and the Rebel Legion characters. We're also represented on the stage here. You'll see some Rebel pilots and Princess Leia and some of the other good guy characters and Jedis. Those folks are from our sister organization called the Rebel Legion's Echo Base. They're the New York chapter of the international costume organization called the Rebel Legion. And they do the good guy costumes. So give everybody them a big round of applause. Then. Now, just to give you a little background, both organizations were formed almost 20 years ago, and what they originally were meant to be was to help different costume people who were interested in Star Wars help create and build accurate costumes that were something like right out of the movie, not, you know, typical Halloween costumes, not something you could buy at the store, something that would be movie accurate, something that would be up to that quality that was indistinguishable from what was in the movies. So of course, the people that were attracted to the group were very have a very good attention to detail. They like to emulate that, you know, best possible impression of that particular character, and that's pretty much what started the whole 501st Legion. But as those folks started gathering and getting together and making these great costumes, they kind of realized very quickly within the first 6 or 7 months of having the organization put together, well, what are we going to do with these costumes? You know, where could we use these costumes outside a convention or outside just wearing them on Halloween? And one of the founders, Alvin Johnson, had the great idea to try to marry this with some local community groups and some charitable groups in the community and offer our services for free as on a fully volunteer basis for any community or charitable organizations. And that's pretty much what got us started doing this. And since then, we've now spread out all around the world. There's garrisons in just about every country. There's a garrison in every state in the United States. And the garrisons range in size from 50 to 100 members. Some of the garrisons, like in Florida and California, have upwards of 400 or 500 members. And worldwide, we have about 8,000 members. And I think, correct me if I'm wrong, the Rebel Legion is somewhere in that 3,000 or 4,000 range as well. So between the good guy group, the good guy group, the Rebel Legion, and the bad guy group, the 501st Legion, there's over 10,000 people around the country and around the world who dress up and make their own Star Wars costumes and use them in the community to benefit the community or for other charitable organizations. Let me start off by just answering some questions that are common questions that we get a lot of times from different audience members. A lot of folks ask us if we're authorized to do this, if we have Lucas and Disney's blessing. I'm very happy to announce that both the Rebel Legion and the 501st Legion do have the blessing of Lucasfilm. Back when we were first starting, back in the late 90s, Lucasfilm had reached out to us around the time that The Phantom Menace was coming out and said, and you know, of course, we were freaking out thinking that it was going to be a cease and desist order or please stop what you're doing immediately. We don't want you associated with, you know, the Star Wars brand. It was exactly the opposite. They reached out to us, said, you know, we see what you guys are doing. We see that you guys are doing this in the community and that you have, you know, a very good charter that says that you're going to do this on a volunteer basis. As long as you keep that up, you're not doing this for profit, and you're doing it as a very positive thing in the community, we're 100% behind you. And then recently, when Disney purchased Lucas, we were also afraid that something would happen. We're very happy to say that they took the same exact tact And they said, guys, as long as you keep doing what you're doing and keep doing it on a volunteer basis, we're behind you 100%. It's great. It's a great brand promotion for us. It lets you guys still do what you're doing. So just keep it up. So we're happy to say that we're authorized by both Lucasfilm and Disney to continue doing what we're doing and operating, helping the community, doing different charitable events. So thank you again for having us here. I'd also like to mention, we are do have some other folks from some other costume organizations. We have folks from the Sabre Guild and folks from Docking Bay 516, and that's Len over here. There are some other smaller groups that we also partner with. The Sabre Guild does things like lightsaber demonstrations, and Docking Bay 516 is a fan force group that also does local charitable events and libraries and things of that nature, so we're happy to have them aboard as well. We've done over 110 events this year. I personally have done 50, much to my wife and two 16-year-old daughters' chagrin, so to speak. But I like to say that, you know, for me, this is my golf. This is my getting out with the boys, getting out with the guys and ladies on the weekends to do our fun stuff, our geek stuff, and also help the community at the same time. So it's hard for my wife to argue when I say I'm going out to go to a polar plunge, or I'm going out to go to a library, or I'm going out to help the United Cerebral Palsy Association like we are today. She's behind me 100%. And I must mention as well, I have 16-year-old twin daughters who do not like Star Wars. So that can be a challenge when I'm trying to show off my new costume and everything to them every 5 minutes. So I failed as a parent in that regard. But they are very charitable at heart. They've come with me to a lot of events. They help out when we do our things like Blast the Trooper to raise money. And I'm glad that I've been part of at least that that charitable spirit to them, if I haven't necessarily gotten them into Star Wars. Does anybody else want to say a few words about the group or about any of the personal experiences of being part of the 501st Rebel Legion? Okay, well, that's a very good point. Anthony was just mentioning, I could mention some of the different costumes that we have. How many of you saw some of the different characters today roaming around and took some pictures? Did everybody see a bunch of characters? Well, today we have represented a number of stormtroopers. We had the original stormtroopers, we had sand troopers, we had the new stormtrooper from the new Force Awakens, we had Boba Fett, we had different Rebel pilots from the Rebel Legion, different Jedis, and of course our Princess Leia, Christine Evans, who does a wonderful Princess Leia. Give her a big round of applause. And we have an Imperial gunner here that Anthony's doing, who you might have seen in the new trailer for the new movie. Is everybody excited about Rogue One coming out?
Yeah!
Very good. Well, we're all very excited. It brings back the old school stormtroopers, so we can break out our old stormtrooper costumes again, and kids will know what we are. After the new movie came out, we were like, darn, are they going to recognize us? But the kids still recognize us anyway. Okay, well, I think I'm going to open it up to some questions. If anybody has a question, you want to come up and ask me your question, we can answer any of your questions you might have about the group, about our costumes. They can run anywhere from $1,000 to about $6,000 or $7,000, depending on the character. I would say on the low end, believe it or not, the Stormtrooper is probably one of the least expensive because it's so common and the parts are readily available. You can do that for under $1,000. Some other costumes like a Boba Fett or a Darth Vader can run you upwards of $6,000 or $8,000 if you go completely movie accurate. So there's a lot of passion, a lot of blood, sweat, and tears that goes into making these costumes, all for, you know, different folks' enjoyment at these different charity events. If anybody has a question, come on.
How do we make this costume?
Well, there are different kits available. There's a company called Anavos that makes a Stormtrooper kit that runs about $600. It costs about another $500 or $600 to put it together and put all the rest of the parts together.